The silk of a spider's web can be up to 5 times stronger than steel. But how can it be so strong? And can we make a steel that is just as strong? If you put a spider web under a powerful microscope, you see that each string is made of thousands and thousands of very tiny fibers. And it turns out that when a material is made of tiny building blocks, like these fibers, it is very strong. And the smaller these building blocks, the stronger the material. But what about steel? Well, turns out that steel is also made of small building blocks. They are too small for us to see with the naked eye, but if you put steel under a microscope, you see that it is entirely made of crystals. Yes, steel is actually made of many and many crystals stuck together. The only problem is that even though these crystals look small to us, they are much bigger than the fibers that make the spider silk. But what if we could make the crystals in the steel just as tiny as the fibers in a spider's silk? Would the steel become stronger? Tougher? The answer is yes! The good news is that we are already capable of creating these tiny crystals. The bad news is that it takes too long. We first have to heat the steel until it is red hot, cool it very fast, and then wait for these tiny crystals to form. How long we have to wait for depends on the steel. It can take from a couple of minutes to days or weeks. There is even a steel at the Science Museum in London that started forming these tiny crystals in 2004, and it will only be ready in 2104. That's 100 years of waiting. Fortunately, we are finding ways to speed up this process. One way of doing this is by cooling the steel a little bit below the temperature we usually cool it. Then, some big crystals start to form very fast, which is not exactly what we want. But when we hold the temperature and wait, the tiny crystals start to form way faster than before. And why is that? We still don't know. And the weird part is that this works way better for some steels than for others, and we also don't know why. That's what my research project is about. I'm trying to figure out how those big crystals make the tiny crystals form faster. If I'm successful, I'll create a set of mathematical equations that can explain and represent this phenomenon. But not only that, these equations will be used by the industry to actually manufacture these strong steels in the fastest possible way. And by creating such strong steels, we can use them to make lighter, stronger cars, which will be safer, resulting in less road deaths, and will emit less CO2, helping to fight climate change. And last but not least, we will show spiders that they're not the only ones who are quick at making super strong materials.